mercy, and he's bringing to be praised. Come on, we have the worshipers, come on, lift your hands in this place. Come on, I'm gonna lock out everything that's in your mind. Lock out anything that's hindering you. Just think about just who God is. Just think about who God is in your life right now. Oh,
atmosphere in this place. And the Holy Spirit put on my heart to have my daughter sing a verse for you this morning.
And if I had to pick a subject for
would say that this was the final preparation. And due to the, because of time, I want you to go home and read this chapter when you go home. But Jesus was preparing the disciples for the trials to come.
Yes,
he was preparing the disciples for the coming of the Holy Spirit. Now, before Jesus would use all kinds of metaphors to tell the disciples what he meant, but in this chapter, he just gave it to them straight. Many of us, we keep listening to the voices talking around us and the thoughts in our head, so much that many are failing to recognize and remember what God has already said. You may be sitting here right now, and you are dealing with some things in life that are making you tired, weary, discouraged. Some of you may be dealing with grief and ready to give up. But I want you to know that God wants you to know that you are not alone. You have the Holy Spirit to comfort you, to teach you truth, and to help you. If you will allow me to just read this same verse from the Message version, it says, I've told you all this so that trusting me, this is Jesus speaking, no one else, trusting me, you will be unshakable and assured. And assured, confident in the one you trust. He goes on to say, deeply at peace. This requires a release. Because peace is not something that has to be made, but it is a gift of God's will. He goes on to say, in this godless world, you will continue. It's simply a choice we make. The way and think a little bit. This is how God gave it to me. So that's how I'm giving it to you. Because he's been talking to many of you already.